Nobody's interested in car. I suffered and suffered and suffered. What they're waiting for is results. Sadly, result. Nobody sees behind the scene. Nobody sees the effort, the cries, the disappointments, the pain. Nobody. Nobody's interested. But the glamour and fantasy, yeah, everybody wants to be part of it. If you ask Christine and her team today how long it took to put this together and the money that was spent, they won't tell you. But we're having a good time today. And we're all here. Same thing can be said about this.
What? What? Why should we take pride in who gets the largest crumbs that falls from the master's table? And I wrote a post, I say it's like two dwarves saying I'm the taller dwarf. No matter how tall a dwarf is, you are still a dwarf. You are still a dwarf. Why is vision important in leadership? Number one says, vision shows us where we are headed. If you enter a dark room, you will grope. You depend on your hand movements, you know, to locate where something is. That's because you cannot see. You just grope in the dark. You grope in darkness. But when there is light, you walk straight to that dispenser. You walk straight to that table to get what you want. That's what vision does for you. It shows you where you are headed. This is where I'm going to. I asked a question recently. I've heard about the American dream. And it was going because you are going to experience burnout. At some point in your life, you will experience burnout. At some point on the organization, you experience burnout. You experience low times. You experience disappointment. But what keeps you going is the vision. He's like an architect after you're drawing a beautiful house and presents it to the owner of the house. And you know, it has passed foundation level, has gotten to the middle level, about to be roofed. No money. Building has stopped. The man will not say, because I don't have money, therefore I abandon this project. He will see the completed edifice, he will see the completed duplex, but on paper. I said, I want to achieve this thing. I want this thing to come to reality. And so it makes him to work hard or even call on friends to help him with funding to be able to achieve what has been drawn on paper so that it can be translated into forward and move through obstacles. There's no better way to say it than this. Absence of funding. I'm currently working with an NGO, so I understand. Absence of funding, no funding, and maybe for 2 years you're thriving on your pockets, your salary. It's a long shot. It's a long shot when you are investing, and nothing seems to be coming. The grants are not coming. It's a long shot. It's a long shot when people are saying, this thing, no matter how, stop now, stop. Why are you crazy? You said something about your why. Your why is very important. Why did you start your organization? Why are you eradicating poverty? Why are you, you know, fostering gender equality and all the SDGs today? Why are you doing what you're doing? Is it for the awards? Is it for accolades? Is it for the grants? You must be able to know your why. If your why is not clear, then you'll be kicked out at any slightest disappointment. Your why must be important. Even as individuals, let's say you don't have an organization, you must have your why for living. It was a great man, Kamau, who said, your dream is not what you see when you sleep. Your dream is what keeps all your people reading every day. Two, have an ambitious end goal. So at 100, What story
strategy you did, and then crucial, this is very important, because some people are so straight jacketed. If not be this way, it's no other way. And they carry that mindset to businesses and their organizations, and they're doing no. The world is dynamic, things have changed. You must be able to change a strategy that is not working and employ another one. So every morning, like Mohammed bin Rashid would say, a gazelle wakes up knowing he has to outrun the lion or be killed. And then the lion knows he must outrun the gazelle or starve. So there's constantly change of strategy on how to escape. So within an execution, if something is not working the right way, you employ another thing. If something is not working, you bring it. That's what will make you to keep thriving, right?
So in 2030, just like the SDGs goal, MDG failed in 2015, they had to reenact SDGs. And 2030 is the year they feel the 17 goals or 16 goals should be accomplished. Sadly, it's not working. Actually, we have not gone into 169 targets, 232 indicators, 16 goals, and we are nowhere to be found. For you, start with the end in mind. And I will close this way. Having talked about vision and how it's important in building our organizations and our individual lives, I want to let you know that at the global dinner of civilization, the global dinner table of civilization, where everybody together, there are three kinds of people. One, the waiters. Two, the diners. Three, the food to be eaten. Africa, over the years, has been the food that is being eaten at the global dinner of civilization. But we pray, as you put this vision in place and work towards achieving greatness with your organization, with your individual lives, Africa will not be the food to be eaten again. Africa will be a diner, not even a waiter, at a global dinner table of civilization. Thank you very much. We'll see you.